something else.
So they were very skillful.
Yeah. But they did show us.
Yeah.
So, and it's good that they showed us, because the technology crashed and burned at Xerox. And what? They used to call the... What's that?
No, I was just...
Why?
Yeah, why?
Oh, very... I actually thought a lot about that. And I learned more about that with John Scully later on. And I think I understand it now pretty well. What happens is, like with John Scully, John came from PepsiCo. And they at most would change their product, you know, once every 10 years. I mean, to them, a new product was like a new size bottle, right? So if you were a product person, you couldn't change the course of that company very much. So who influenced the success of PepsiCo? The sales and marketing people. Therefore, they were the ones that got promoted, and therefore, they were the ones that ran the company. Well, for PepsiCo, that might have been okay. But it turns out the same thing can happen in technology companies that get monopolies. Like, oh, IBM and Xerox. If you were a product person at IBM or Xerox, so you make a better copy or a better computer. So what? When you have a monopoly market share, the company's not any more successful. So the people that can make the company more successful are sales and marketing people. And they end up running the companies. And the product people get driven out of the decision-making forums. And the companies forget what it means to make great products. It sort of the product sensibility and the product genius that brought them to that monopolistic position gets rotted out by people running these companies who have no conception of a good product versus a bad product. They have no conception of the craftsmanship that's required to take a good idea and turn it into a good product. And they really have no feeling in their hearts, usually, about wanting to really help the customers. So that's what happened at Xerox. The people at Xerox Park used to call the people that ran Xerox toner heads. And they just had, and these toner heads would come out to Xerox Park, and they just had no clue about what they were seeing.
And for our audience, toner is what?
Oh, toner. Toner is what you put into a copier. Yeah, the, you know, the toner that you add to an industrial copier.
The black stuff.
The black stuff, yeah. So basically, they were copier heads that just had no clue about a computer or what it could do. And so they just grabbed... grab defeat from the greatest victory in the computer industry. Xerox could have owned the entire computer industry today. Could have been, you know, a company 10 times its size. Could have been IBM. Could have been the IBM of the 90s. Could have been the Microsoft of the 90s. So, but anyway, that's all ancient history. It doesn't really matter anymore.
Sure.